It was an awesome, awesome book. Be mindful that this Tuesday at 7 is Celebrate Recovery. Amen. If you have not been a part of Celebrate Recovery, if you feel like, I don't need Celebrate Recovery, we all need Celebrate Recovery. It's just a tool that helps you be a better you. Amen. And it holds us accountable. Elder Clyde teaches Celebrate Recovery, and it is an awesome class. We want to remind you of Wednesday night Bible study. Wednesday night Bible study at 7. Wednesday night Bible study at 7 is still on Zoom. Amen. We send out the link. Bible study has been on. Amen. And you get an opportunity to chime in and ask a question or talk or comment if you want to. So please, Wednesday nights be on Bible study. Amen. And always Friday night prayer. Friday night prayer. Pastor Ron will send out the link and they pray over whatever the issues are. Pray over each other, our leaders, our country, whatever the need is. If you have a need, please be on the line for Friday night prayer. Amen. And so we just wanted to make sure that each and every one of you know what's going on. If you do not know what's going on or how to get connected, we have a church app, amen, and so that you can keep it right on your phone and you can get all the updates for everything. If you do not have the church app, let us know and we will show you how to get the church app. There are some cards. Where's Sister? Brother Al. There are some little cards back there and they have a QR code on them that you can just scan that with your phone and it will let you know what's what. It'll let you know how to give. A lot of you were saying you didn't know where to give or how to give. You can give right through there. There are many opportunities and many ways. At any time during this service, whether you're online or you're here, you have the opportunity to just come up and drop it in the basket. Amen. Because we want to be givers because we want to give, not because somebody told us to give. Amen. It's about the obedience unto the Lord. So God knows your heart and he knows where you are. I don't have to. Because God does. Amen. Amen. So we want all the mothers to raise their hands. Our children have something for you. Amen. All of the children, go help Miss Barb. Okay. She's got something for you to pass out to the moms. Yes. What you want? No. We're passing out to the, y'all gonna make me cry.
We love you, Pastor Taylor.
I love you too, Brother Jason. Thank you.
From the men's.
Amen. Oh, thank you.
Good morning.
So those are pretty.
We're not on the elders announcement, but we just wanted to bless our pastor for Mother's Day. Some of us in the women's ministry, some are our quarters together.
Amen.
So she could take a trip.
What?
Just around the block.
Okay, thank you, Jesus. My heart.
So this is from the women's ministry. We love you.
Thank you. I love you too, Sister Bobby. Ladies, thank you. We can have a couple of these a week. Amen. You know what we are all, make sure that all the ladies have, did everybody, every lady? Huh? All our moms? If raise your hand, Sister Crystal hasn't gotten anything yet. We want to make sure that every one of you feels special. Now, there's a couple of things in that bag that you need to know about. Ladies, I want you to go home, kick your shoes off, put your face mask on, sit back and relax, We want you to learn how to take care of yourselves because we're mothers and we do a whole lot. There's some special hand cream in there. You know, some of our hands can get rough as nails. Ladies, come on. We got to take care of ourselves. So this is just the beginning. If your kids are telling you to pamper yourself, we know we need to do something. Amen. Hallelujah. We pray that you are blessed. We love each and every one of you, and we wish you a very happy Mother's Day. Amen. Thank you to the men's ministry. Thank you to the women's ministry. I appreciate you more than you know. On yesterday, we had a celebration for our ladies. We had a ladies' tea. And if any of you know me, you know I love to have tea parties.
And I like to have tea parties, but I like to have fancy tea parties. I like, we got to eat on China, huh? And we had the men's service. Come on, give the men a hand for yesterday. Hallelujah. It was an awesome time in the Lord. The men were serving. Look at us. They served us tea. We were having a good time. They were laughing and enjoying. We had lots of food, lots of fun, and lots of fellowship. Come on, we had an awesome time. We had an awesome time. Woo! Yes. They served us well. They honored us well. Amen. And we are grateful and thankful for all the time and the fun that we had on yesterday. Well, you know, at this time we have a special song that we are going to sing. We always need the Spirit of the Lord to move on us and in us and through us in all that we do. Amen. Where is Sister Lauren? There she is. Hallelujah. We just want to say Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. Can't tell you enough. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pass it around. You want to take these for me? Look like part of my outfit, don't you? You need me to help you or no? You okay? Okay, good. Go up to the front. Go up to the front. To, yes. Hallelujah.
Nothing stays the same. Everything's broken. There is another name. Spirit is moving. Burning like a flame. Healing the broken. What we proclaim. Raise it up. Tears will fall, mountains will move, we lift them high.
Come on, baby.
Speak a name above all other names.
Speak the name the wind and rain obey.
All the burdens coming down, fill the earth.
Come on, hallelujah. At the mention of your name, hallelujah.
Our darkness is clean. Mercy rain down.
Yes.
Healing water flowing as our lips make the sound. Raise it up, fill the sky. Tears will fall, mountains will lift him high. Speak the name above all other names.
Speak the name the wind and rain obey. All the fear is coming down.
Fill the earth
with the sound of the name of Jesus. Speak the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hearts can stay free.
So good. Well, it's Mother's Day, so today is me. Amen. Hallelujah. God is so good to us. He's so good to us. And just like the words to that song says, we need to speak the name of Jesus. Amen. We need to speak the word. We need to say what God says about the matter. Amen. In concerning all things, especially when it comes to mothers. Come on, especially when it comes to mothers. We got to speak the word about what God said about us. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you know that it is an honor to be a woman, huh? In and of itself, whether you're a mother or not, huh? It is an honor to be a woman because God has something special for us. Amen. He has something special for us. If you've got your Bibles, go to the book of Exodus. Hallelujah. And we're going to release our children to Children's Church. Hallelujah. At this time. Hallelujah. Speak the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There's power in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to Exodus, the 20th chapter, and then we're going to go to Proverbs 31. Amen. Hallelujah. I got a lot going on up here. Okay. Exodus chapter 20. Now let me get back to Exodus. Hallelujah. If we can stand in reverence to God's word, you know, God's is holy. And so we need to reverence him every chance that we get. And one of the things I'm going to talk about today is the comparison of how God loves us to how a mother loves a child. That's a great love. Amen. Exodus, the 20th chapter and the 12th verse. It says, honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. And then in Proverbs 31, verse 30, it says, favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord shall be praised. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word. Amen. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for your word. God, we thank you for this day, each and every mother represented here. But Lord, most of all, we ask that you would open our ears and our heart to receive what the Spirit of the Lord would say. We thank you that you will cause us to be doers of your word and not just hearers. As we give you honor, glory, and praise, in Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand praise as we have our seats this morning. Hallelujah. God is just so good to us. Well, mothers, today is your day. And my assignment from the Lord today is to help you to be free in being a mother. Amen? Help you to be free in being a woman. Because sometimes as women, we are so bound up by the life that we have lived and what we feel like we didn't do right and we didn't do enough of, and we made this mistake and we made that mistake. We are so bound up with that we can't do what God has called us to do. Amen? And so I want you to know something, that a mother is described as many different things. There are many different aspects to being a mother. A mother is loving. She is appreciative. A mother, it can be weeping, and she's always remembering. Amen? A mother is loving because God is loving. Amen? How many of you know that we were created in the image of God, huh? Each and every one of us. And God is love. And so as a woman, you were created to love. You were created to nurture. Amen? You were created to bring life. You are the only other thing outside of God that brings life. Did you realize that? You can do a lot of things. Men can do a lot of things. And I don't care what kind of surgery they have today or whatever they try to do. They cannot bring life. Come on. They do not have a womb. Amen? I don't care how they want to figure it out and what they want to do. A woman, you are the only thing that can bring the life that God gives. Amen? Amen. Now, y'all can go grow some bugs in a jar or something like that, but God is the only one that gives the life that we're talking about. And so you are unique, and you are fearfully and wonderfully made, and there is something special about you that God has designed just for you. And so I want you to be able to embrace that fact that God made you in a very, very special way. Amen? Mothers are nurturers. We nurture by just giving nature. You nurture your children. You nurture your husband. You nurture your friends. You even nurture people you don't even know. We care about everything and everybody. And you saying, now, I know some women that ain't like that. Those are the ones we just need to pray for. But we nurture. We love. We protect. We cover our children. We cover our households. I want you to understand just how important you are. I want you to leave here with your head so big that you can't get through that door back there. Huh? Because you've realized who you are in Christ. And you realize what God has given you. You realize the power and the favor that you have with God. Matter of fact, your husband doesn't have favor with the Lord if he ain't right with you. That's the word. The power and the favor that God has given us, a woman. If we just knew who we were. I've often said, if I knew what I know now, when I was 18, they would have had to put a sticker on me that said lethal. Because now I know who I am. See, God know the world wasn't even ready for that. And that's what you have to understand. There's greatness in you. And God wants to pull it out. But the world wants you to feel condemned. The world wants you to feel like you're not good enough. The world wants you to feel like you made a mistake. You had sex outside of marriage. You had 3 kids before you got married. You got 5 kids and you ain't even married. What good are you? God said, you're great and I can use that. God uses everything. Everything is a testimony. Every failure that you've had in your life is a testimony. Don't let the enemy lie to you and tell you that you're not good enough and you can't and you won't and nobody will use you and nobody will let you do this or let you do that. The devil is a lie. See, so I'm here today to help you to understand the power that you have. Women, I'm going to act like the men ain't in the room for just a second. They don't even know. They have no clue what they got in us. They have no clue. Told you this, Pastor Ron. He don't even know what God has given us. It's the power that God has put inside of us just to be us. To be quiet when we need to be quiet? Huh? To walk away when we need to walk away? To shut it down when we need to shut it down? God has given us the power that we need to be overcomers in this life. So stop letting people and this world tell you that you're not, because God said you that you are. Amen? Stop letting anybody tell you that you can't and you won't, because God said that you can. He also said that greater is he that is within us than he that is within the world. So if God has told us that we're great and that we have this power and we have the authority that he's given us, look, now all of this comes with following the word. Don't get it twisted. You can't be a hellion and think God don't bless you. Huh? That's, God don't roll like that. Huh? That's not the way it goes. To whom much is given, much is required. God has given us all these great gifts, but we can't just do what we want to do. We've got to live it according to the Lord. It's like that, the scripture in Proverbs that I read. The end of that says, a woman that fears the Lord. Huh? If you fear the Lord and have the favor of the Lord. See, some of you are living in this life where your children don't respect you. Huh? They get mad at you. They'll cuss at you just like they would have anybody in the street. They'll tell you, you can't tell me what to do. I'm grown, living in your house, driving your car, eating your food, huh? Wearing your clothes on their back. And they want to tell you what to do. That's this world that we live in. Because society says that there doesn't have to be any more respect. And they can do what they want to do because they're grown. Guess what? I'm grown, but I am not going to treat my parents any kind of way. Huh? Not gonna treat God any kind of way? It's just not gonna happen. We live in a society where kids think they don't have to respect their parents. And that's because y'all scared that they gonna call 911. Well, you know what? You need to call 911 first. And tell them, y'all meet me at the house because I'm finna tear these hind parts up. See, we need to understand that God said, spare the rod, what? He said, if you beat him, he will not die. We need to put some order back in things. And as mothers, come on, you set the tone in the household. You set the tone for your family. So if things ain't going right in the house with the kids and the kids is disrespectful, they don't respect you, they don't respect their father, no adult, they want to do what they want to do, something's wrong. What tone are you setting in the house? Mothers, God has called us to be an example. You can't do what the kids do. If you're going to be mama, you can't be hanging out at the club with the kids. Come on. If you can't be mama, your dress can't be shorter than the daughter's dress. If you're going to be the mama, you can't have on more makeup and trying to catch Bobo over there because Bobo's looking at your daughter, but you're looking at Bobo. If you're going to be a mama, you're going to have to be a mama. See, everybody, there are many mothers out there, but there are few mamas. And there's a difference. If you're going to be somebody's mama, that means that you're a prayer warrior. You're a child of God. You walk in the things that God has called you to. You use the tools and the weapons that he's given you in his word. And because we're nurturers and we take care of things and we make things right and we try to fix them, when you are living a life that does not glorify God, guess what? You nurture that too. The longer you stay in it, the harder it is to get out of it. And you will nurture and foster the fact that, hey, me and my daughter, we best friends. Hey, hey, hey. And you're supposed to be mama. There's no respect. There will be no respect if you do the same things that your kids do. God has given you the power and authority to take authority over what the enemy is trying to do to our kids today. I don't know about you, but when it comes to taking care of your kids and the people that God had put in your life to nurture, that's when you have to fight. When's the last time some of y'all had a fight? Come on. A real fight. Huh? I ain't had a fight in a while, so I might hurt somebody. But you take that out on the enemy and not on each other. You've got to learn how to fight for what God gave you. Do you love your children? Do you love your husband? Do you love your family? Then you have to fight for it, ladies. Come on, that's God. That's what God says. You got to fight for it. Now, y'all will look. Before y'all got married and found that boyfriend and girlfriend, you was fighting for that man. Y'all fight for the man, you'll lose your best friend behind the man. Kick mama to the curb behind the man. Stop talking to people behind the man. They ain't God. They can't do nothing for you. Any pleasure that they can give you in this life is only temporary. We need to understand God wants you to see the greatness in you and to stop settling for what the world has given. Stop settling for what the world has given. What is it that you want to do? Somebody tell me, anybody raise their hand, what is it that you want to do? Not what mama wants you to do, but what do you want to do? Y'all don't want to do nothing? Well, I do. What do y'all want to do? Y'all want to travel. You want to open your own clinic. What'd you say? Please, God. Come on. Why aren't we doing it? There's nothing stopping us. Literally nothing. The only thing stopping you from doing what God has called you to do is you. And it's usually procrastination. It's usually procrastination because God has given you everything that you need. Oh, Pastor Pam, I don't have enough money to do that. Did you ask the Lord? Did you ask God? Did you say, Lord, this is what I want to do. This is how I want to do it. Or did you just say, well, we've been working at it. And when we get enough saved up, you ain't gonna never get enough saved up. Because in all things, you're supposed to submit your plans to God first. See, if we just work out the things the way that God called us to and stop trying to do it our own way, ladies, the sky is the limit. There's nothing that you can do. You always hear him say, behind every good man is a what? Behind every good man is a good woman. Now, are you a woman or are you a good woman? Huh? Are you a mother or are you a good mother? Huh? There's a difference. A lot of people can be a mother. But when that turns from mother to mommy, you're doing something. It makes a difference. You're leading, you're guiding, you're directing your children, your loved ones. You ought to be an example. In Proverbs, it says her children are raised up and call her blessed. How many of you guys' kids are blessing you every day? They're calling you blessed. Woo, mom, I love you so much, you blessed. Or are they calling you a low-down, no-good so-and-so because you didn't do what I wanted you to do? The Word of God says that you'll rise up and call her blessed. But you've got to be walking and living and acting like a blessing. Amen? You've got to be doing your part. There's no way to be a perfect mother, but there are a million ways to be a really great one. No way to be a perfect mother. God didn't make you perfect. Let's clear this up right now. Whoever you are, however you are, wherever you are, whatever you are doing, whatever you have been through, God wants to use it all. So instead of lying to your children and telling them that you've been perfect all your life, and baby, I don't make mistakes, and mommy is always right, and I do this, and you're so perfect that they can't see you, start telling them the truth. Guess what? Baby, I don't want you to live a life and step in all these holes. You don't have to be a prostitute. You don't have to lie. You don't have to have sex outside of marriage. You don't have to cheat. You don't have to steal. You don't have to do all of these things. Not because I said so, because I'm going to tell you the truth and the reality of what it is. Help your kids to understand where you've been so that they don't have to step in the same hole that you stepped in. Stop hiding it and covering it up and trying to live a life and make everybody think you're perfect. Nobody's perfect. God uses crackpots. All of us is cracked up in here. Nobody's perfect. Everybody's been through something. Everybody's an ex something. What did you used to do? Huh? Were you a liar, a cheater? Huh? Were you unfaithful? Whatever it was that you used to do, guess what? You used to do it. So now it's a testimony in your life. Stop being afraid to tell where God has brought you from. Because if you tell your babies the truth, they will understand what God can do in their lives. But if you try to hide it and just be perfect all the time, They're going to grow up with a falsehood that this is what it's supposed to be. This is the sense of reality. And maybe you grew up and you were perfect. You never made a mistake. You didn't do anything wrong. Like the man in the Bible when he was talking to Jesus. And he says, I've given all of this. I do everything right. I'm doing this all the time. He said, okay, well, go and sell everything that you have. Uh-oh. Now, wait a minute, Lord. That's my stuff. Hear me. Don't let God have to require everything that you have of you before you realize that you could make a change. God wants you to have all that you have, but the stuff can have you more than God, because some of us have Louis Vuitton bags and Gucci luggage and diamonds so big you can't carry them on your hand, and you live in an apartment. Hear me. God wants there to be order in everything about you. Ladies, you set the tone for the household. There's no reason you should be walking around with red bottoms and your kids are walking around with no bottoms on their shoes. Hear me. I know y'all said, boy, she's just all up in our business today. No, I want you to be better, because God said, if you realize and face, if you face it, you can trace it and you can erase it. Amen. And then nobody, the enemy can't taunt you with where you are, the life that you have lived, because every day is a new day. And tomorrow can be better than today if you just make the choice to do what God has called you to do. And so don't let the enemy hold you back. Ladies, you got to learn how to walk in the freedom that God has given you. We go out of our way to be good mothers. I know you do. We let our kids get away with a lot of things just because our little heart won't let us say no. How many of you have your child asked you something and you didn't have the heart to say no? You look at their little face and you just say, oh. And don't let it be a grandchild. Smeeter can ask me anything and I'm going to sell the house. What you want, baby? Why? Because we love them so much and we nurture them so much. Hear me. That's how God loves you.
Say it again.
That's how God loves you. No matter what, he gave his only begotten son so that you and I could live a life that would bring him glory. Mothers, take your rightful place in the kingdom of God and what he's called you to do. Stop competing and comparing. And start trusting God for what he has for you to do in your life. You need to know your strength lies in the joy of the Lord. A real mother has a relationship with the Lord. And you can say, well, I know somebody ain't saved and she's pretty good to her kids. Do you think that God is not taking care of her too? Huh? Even when you don't, even when you didn't know God, God was taking care of you. How many of you lived a life before you got saved and you know God was taking care of you? He does take care of us, but he wants that all of us would have a relationship that brings him honor, glory, and praise. Know this. Know that you can't rely on your own insights. You got to trust God with your children. I know for me personally, I decided, okay, Pastor Ron and I were in the ministry, but we were evangelizing and we were traveling. And we would drop one suitcase and come and pick up another suitcase. And I had my kids, the teachers were just like, here's your stack of work, because I'm taking my kids with me. And then we got to the place that we were homeschooling our kids and that we were traveling. Hear me, it's a choice that you have to make. It's a choice that you have to make. In this world that we live in today, guess what? I'm surely about to rip the boys out of school and homeschool. I said I'm going to let them try. Definitely before they get in middle school, they will be homeschooled. Why? Because you have to be the biggest influence in their life. Our kids come home from school and you got to deprogram them with all of the crazy stuff that they, I'm like, where did you get that? Ladies, mothers, it's time for you to go back to the schoolhouse and let the school know what your plans are, not just follow their plan. Huh? It's time for you to go into the schools, wherever your children are. If your kids are grown and out of school, it's time for you to sit down and have a talk and say, you know what? I understand that you are grown, but there are some things that you need to know, that you need to live by, and this is the way it's going to be. They might get mad for a minute, but it is better to plant a seed that would save their soul than allow the enemy to take them to hell, and you have to watch it. God said you were warriors. You were warriors. It's like Deborah in the Bible. Deborah was a judge. That she was a bad girl. Deborah was a warrior. She was like a sniper with the word of God. You need to be a sniper on behalf of your children, amen? For the things of this world, everything that the enemy is shooting, you need to snipe them and take them out. And you do that in prayer. It's not good enough to say, oh Lord, just bless my babies today. Y'all gonna have to get on your face and sling some snot, lay on the ground and cry out until God answers your prayer. Because the enemy is trying to take your children out of here. The word of God says this here. It says, honor your mother and your father that your days might be long on this land that the Lord thy God giveth thee. Why do you think we got so many kids dying all the time? Because they don't respect us. They don't do what we say. It said, honor your mother and father. Why do you think honor is so important to God? He said, honor your mother and your father that your days might be long. We got kids dying before parents. Because they just refuse. Some of them just refuse. And your life can be cut short. That is a passage that talks about your lifeline being cut short by being disobedient. And we can't just blame the kids all the time because who's raising them? You cannot blame the kids all the time because who's raising them? What are they seeing you do? How are they seeing you talk? Do you come to church and say, "Woo, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus," fall all out in the floor and cuss the kids out on the way to the car? It's time for us to live an example, to set an example. If you don't have children, you still need to set an example. If you are single, hear me. Single women, if you are single, you cannot be out there shaking your behind and expect every child that you see not to want to do what you're doing. And then when they do, they get in trouble. Some of that is with mothers. Mama, you can't be on the phone talking and gossiping, just doing what you want to do, and expect the kids not to do what you're doing. Those of you that are married, you can't be disrespectful to your husband and everybody else. Don't cook, don't clean, house nasty. And expect that the kids gonna grow up and not do the same thing. I don't know why she can't get married. It's important that we be an example. It's important that we set the stage, amen? Know that you can't rely on yourself, but you gotta rely on God. Know that your highest purpose is to seek God, amen? Take time. Listen, ladies, how many of you got a devotional? Y'all got a devotional book, a pen, or something. Take time to spend with God. That's where your answers are. Guess what? This is not negotiable. The word of God says, seek me. Huh? Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all of these things will be added unto you. Some of y'all wailing and crying and trusting God to do something in your family and for your kids, and you ain't spend no time with him. You got to spend time with God. You got to trust him. You got to lay before him. And guess what? It's not quantity of time. It's quality of time. Whatever time you have for God, if it's 5 minutes, give him your best 5 minutes. Don't let anything take place of God and go first. We are so busy. Some ladies, sometimes we're so busy and trying to impress a man that don't care nothing about you. And that don't have to be your husband or your boyfriend. That can be somebody on your job or just a stranger that look good to you that you seen walking down the street. It is time for us to open our eyes because the enemy is playing for keeps. Hear me. He's playing for keeps. Mothers, it's time to go to war for your children. I don't care where they are or what they're doing. It's not too late. It's never too late with God. Do you understand me? I don't care if they say no, you keep praying. I don't care if they say they don't want to, you keep praying. God says that we can have what we say. That's what the word of God says. So what are you speaking? Are you speaking life? Or you telling them, no, you ain't gonna never be nothing. You just like your daddy. He wasn't nothing. You yourself. No. We need to speak life. You need to let your children know that they are blessed and that they are covered with the power and the love of God. Amen. Mothers nurture in so many different ways. Like I said, we nurture our friends and everything. And even women, we nurture our husbands. How many of you know about Abigail in the Bible? She was married to Nabal. Nabal was a fool. His name means fool. And so some of us got a fool. And all things, God said, we can have household salvation, huh? We just got to turn that thing around by our obedience. If you're married to a fool, you can't change him, but God can. You can't change him, but God can. See, God will so position things so that it works out right for you. Nabal was not good to Abigail at all. He didn't treat her well. And someone came to him and asked him to do something, and he just refused. You know what Abigail did? She went, waited till he was aside, and she went and she said, you know what? I'm putting this before you because my husband didn't honor you, but I want to honor you. I want to do this. See, because he was a fool. He wasn't making the right decisions. You finna mess up everything for your family. She didn't embarrass him. She just went behind and done. And what happened is he ended up dying, and she ended up getting remarried to someone else and was blessed because of a kindness that she made, because she had the wisdom. See, sometimes we follow people that don't have the wisdom, don't have the knowledge or the understanding to do what's right. They're only thinking about themselves. Ladies, it's time to put your hat on. Huh? It's time to get the mind of Christ. It's time to ask God how you're supposed to move. See, a real woman prays for her husband and for her children. You know, in biblical times that it was the women that went out and worked? Guess what? That's still happening today. It was the women that went out at the work. The men went to the gate and took care of business, but she took care of everything. She sewed. She made sure the house was in order, that the kids were in order. She did everything. And guess what? It used to have joy to it. But now we're so tired, by the time the kids get out of school, we're like, oh, they're out of school. Because we're so overwhelmed with all this stuff that we have going on in life. God is saying it's time to take your time back. It's time to take your mind back. It's time to get your heart right. It's time to get in position for what he's called you to do. Everything that you need to do and to be a good mother and a good wife and a good friend and a good person as a woman, everything that you need is already in you. It's just time for you to let it out. So I'm asking you to give yourself the freedom and the grace to trust that God knows better than you, and to do what he's called you to do. If there's some changes that you need to make in your life, stop procrastinating about it and make the changes. Stop doing the same thing every day expecting it to be different. Well, come on. And just because you are the mother doesn't mean that you know everything, even though we think we do. We tell our children that. God is the only one that knows everything. And God is the one that you have to stand on, and you have to believe what he says. You have to trust in his word. You got to be faithful to him at all times, at all points. Amen. You got to know who you are. And you have to learn how to unbecome some things. Did you hear what I said? Unbecome some things. So there are some things that you are right now that you need to unbecome. How do you unbecome something? You stop doing it. There's a mindset that we have. Guess what? You need to change your thinking. You have to unbecome some things. If you're not a good mother, then you need to unbecome being a bad mother, huh? And become a good mother. I told you there's no perfect one, but you can do a lot of things to be a great one, amen? You need to leave a legacy for your children. If something were to happen to you today, what would your children say about you? Oh, I miss my mom. I love my mom. But did mama teach you anything? What did your mom teach you to do? Ladies, I want to hear. Somebody tell me something that your mom taught you to do. What else did she teach you to do? Yeah. Huh? To be in tech. What did your mom teach? You know why? Because only what your mom taught you is what you had to teach your kids. You should have learned some things on your own. But seriously, come on. Some of us, guess what? Mama didn't teach you anything. Some of y'all learned from the girl's mama next door. Or from a friend's mother. Or from what you saw somebody else do. Women, we watch each other all the time. And we look at other women and you might say, I like that. I think I'll use that. I like Sister Virginia. I like that. I think I'm going to use it. I like Sister Terry. I think I'm going to use that. What are you teaching your children? What legacy are you leaving for them? I want more than just to say, oh, I love my mama. She was nice. What legacy are you leaving? What are you leaving for? Especially, what are you leaving for your daughters? Women, ladies, do you realize it's just as important for you to teach your sons as it is for you to teach your daughters? Your son needs to know how to grow up and treat a woman. And if you allow yourself to be mistreated in front of your son, he's going to mistreat whoever he gets. If you allow yourself to be broken down and can't talk and misspoke, that's exactly what your children are going to allow. You've got to show them something more and show them something better. And none of us have been perfect. I know that I'm not a perfect mom. I work at it pretty hard, though. But none of us are perfect. And just like you, guess what? There are things and areas I need to say, Lord, I need you to help me with this. Because I'm having a hard time telling this child no. I'm having a hard time not stepping in and taking care of this for her or for him. God, I'm having a hard time learning with this growing up thing. God, now they're married and they talking to me like they know better than me. Come on. These are all the different stages of life that you have to go through. And sometimes as mothers, we don't understand what happens when my sweet little girl goes from, mommy, mommy, I love you, to hanging on to everything that you say. And then she grows up, and when she gets to be about 60, some little boy says, hey. And then she ain't listening to you so much because she's trying to listen to him. Huh? Come on, and then you get them through school, and there's always somebody pulling at them and hanging on them, and they got to decide, are they going to act like they're friends, or are they going to do what you told them to do? Are they going to follow what you said, or are they going to follow what the world is saying? And then they grow up, and they get their own job, and they get their own money, and then it's hard for you to say anything to them because I'm grown. Yeah, you're grown. But that doesn't change your heart. That didn't change your mind as a mother. That didn't change anything that you were used to doing as a mother. And so it's hard to allow your children to grow up and become who God has called them to be. But I'm telling you this, hear me. It is worth it. It is worth it to deal with them now. Because if you don't deal with them now, they may not be there for you to deal with later. It is so worth it for you to pour in the prayer. Call out to God. Make the hard decisions. Sometimes we have to make some very tough decisions that will break our heart, but you never know what God has planned in the end. And I need to say this. God is so good to us. And if you are a parent, if you are a godparent, You need to honor it. I try to treat my godchildren like my own children. I try to honor them to the best of my ability. Why? Because I chose that. I tried to set an example. I tried to love them in spite of. And sometimes you have to make some hard decisions. And you have to be able to tell them something that they may not necessarily like. And I remember having that situation with one of my godchildren. And I said, I love you, but right is right and wrong is wrong. And the choice is yours as to what you do. When they disappear, that doesn't start the heartbreak, but God. See, as a mother, as a godmother, huh, whatever, you continue to pray. You continue to fast. You continue to love. You continue to do everything that you are supposed to do, and God will bring them back. Because God knows the plan for their life. You don't. God will bring them back because it's all about Him. And so, ladies, don't ever think that I can let this slide. I don't have to deal with it as a mother because I don't want to. I don't want to hurt their feelings. Hurt their feelings and save them. They will come back. That's what the Word of God says. Train them up in the way that they should go. And when they get old, they won't depart. And they'll come back. And God will have them at the right place at the right time doing the right thing. But ladies, it's all about us making a choice. It's all about us making a choice. Mothering is more about making peace with what you can't control, huh? And confidently relying on God to use whatever happens for His glory with your children. It's for His glory. Stop trying to change things and manipulate things. Ladies, guess what? Don't manipulate your children. That's witchcraft. Manipulation is witchcraft. Well, I was just trying to steer them in the right way. Then just flat out tell them what you want to say and stop trying to coach them into something else. Well, I was just trying. No. You was just trying. See, you was trying. Tell them the truth and shame the devil. That's how we're going to have a generation of children that can grow up and be self-sufficient. Do you realize that kids today can't do nothing on their own? You go into the school. You got a baseball team. Everybody wins. Everybody shouldn't get the trophy on the team. If you ain't good enough, you don't need a trophy. You just made the team. Be happy you're on the team. So they can't deal with the cares of this life because school is teaching them everybody wins. No, you didn't make one point. Baby been on the bench the whole thing, and he got the biggest trophy. That's a false sense of security. And it's teaching our children not to learn how to deal with life. Parents, you got to tell them the truth so that they can deal with life. Because the first thing that comes their way that upsets them, they won't be able to handle it. And that's why we got so many kids trying to do things to themselves. Because they can't handle life. Because you won't tell them the truth. That's my baby. Whoop your baby. Help them to understand. You don't have to act like that. There's another way to get there. And that way is Jesus. Your baby's got to learn how to call on Jesus for themselves. They got to have a relationship with the Lord. When my girls were little, when they got in trouble, when they were in school, I think Brittany made it to, she made it to the sixth grade. Desiree, you made it to the fourth grade. Rhonda was in kindergarten, and I would get calls like, Mrs. Frierson, Desiree is laying hands on people on the playground. She's praying for the kids. I'd be like, yes! Brittany went to school that sixth grade year. She was like, Mom, I come home every day. I feel like I just need a bath because all the kids talk about is sex and stuff. And I said, okay, last day of school. But one day she asked her teacher. Her teacher called and she said, Mrs. Frierson, Brittany is harassing. She said, hi, harassing people. And I said, what do you mean harassing people? Well, she's telling people that they're going to hell. And I said, okay. I said, well, Brittany, what did you, I said, well, who are people? She said, well, Brittany said, Mom, I didn't tell her that she was going to hell. I said, if you don't know Jesus, you going to hell. Because she asked her teacher, was she saved? She said, are you saved? Do you know Jesus? And her teacher's kind of, oh, well, I'm a good person. She said, I asked you that. I want to know if you know Jesus. She said, I didn't tell her if she didn't know him. I said, if she didn't know him, she was going to hell. And I didn't just say she was going to hell. Guess what? I will back that 100%. I'll be the first one into school backing it 100%. It's even now with my boys. Zakai tells, Kai and Zakai tell everybody, hey, did you guys know I'm a son of a preacher? That's what they tell the kids at school. It's got to start somewhere. It's got to start somewhere. We've got to get the word in them. Mothers, it starts with you. It starts with you. Get the word in them. It's never too late. Plant the seed. Plant the seed. It's just that important. How many of you love your children? Men and women. Everybody, we love our children. If you don't have children, if you are a child, do you love your parents? Okay, then the word of God says, honor thy father and mother, that thy days might be long, huh? On this earth that the Lord thy God giveth thee. God said, honor your parents. If you want to be around here any length of time, I mean, time is winding up. It's getting short. And we are living in perilous times. And I'm telling you, ladies, your children cannot make it without your prayers. They cannot make it without your love and without your backing. That doesn't mean give them everything that they want. Because then nobody can't tell them no. Hello? You got kids that think that they can do anything that they want to do, have anything that they want to have. So they walk in the store and they grab what they want and they walk out and they ain't got no money. So they go into jail. Then you gonna cry for the next 5 years and not be able to function, miss it out on all that God has called you behind one when you had 10. God is saying it's time for us to pull it together. It's time for us to get it together. Ladies, no mistake that you have ever made in your life, God has not already forgiven you for. You just need to learn how to forgive yourself. So I want to free you up this morning to be able to walk in the love and the favor and the grace of God. Amen? You play a lot of roles to our children. You the gourmet chef, the taxi driver, the party planner, the administrative coordinator, huh? The comforter in chief. The night watch woman. We have all of these hats and positions that we can wear. Guess what? Those are just byproducts of the love of Christ that is within us. Don't let your children miss out on knowing the Lord because you didn't live it before them. Or you didn't show them. Guess what? And if you have not lived that life before them, start today. It's never too late. How many of you know that your kids love you anyway? They're resilient. You can spank them, and the next minute they're on your leg. They can be in trouble. They can be in punishment. They might be bad, but let something happen. Ooh. It doesn't matter how old they get. I'm going to use this example, Desiree. It doesn't matter how old they get. They still need you to take care of them. They still need you to take care of them. Now, I'm thinking, you know, Des is grown. But as a mom, I want to always be able to take care of you. You're always going to be my baby. Hear me. That's what God thinks about you. You're always going to be his baby, no matter how old you get. And she was sick. And and Desiree is usually downstairs in the basement in her own place. But she was upstairs. And she didn't feel good. And she wouldn't say anything. Now, the girl's throwing up in the bathroom, throwing up all over the place, bent over. And I got up. I said, the light is still on. I said, what is going on? I got up, and I walked in the bathroom, and she's laying on the floor. All balled up, throwing up, coming from both ends. It wasn't good. She was sick. And I said, Dad, and she was like, wah. And I just looked at her and I cleaned up the throw up and I picked up everything and I picked her up and I gave her medicine and she threw up again and I just kept cleaning it up and wiping her up and she kept saying, I'm so sorry, Mom, I'm so sorry. I'm thinking, you're sick, child. I'm so sorry. The lesson of that is this. Don't lay there where you don't have to lay there all by yourself. God is telling you, don't lay there in your own sickness when all you had to do was ask me. All you had to do was ask me. It was my honor. I cleaned up the throw up and everything else that was up. It was my honor. Why? Because that's my baby. I love her. God said it is his honor to clean up your mess. It is his honor to clean up your mess because he loves you. He loves you. I was so happy. I was like, Dad, let me take care of her. Because when they get older, they can take care of themselves. But never forget that God is always there. Because whether you are 2 or 92, you always need Jesus. Always. So allow God to reach down and touch you. And start you this day. Start a new beginning right where you are. The principle of Shamgar. Start where you are with what you have and move forward. And if you have not been all that you could have been, guess what? Today you are. You step over this line. Huh. Old things have passed away. I'm looking ahead. I don't know what's happening back there. I'm a new creature in Christ, huh? I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Every mistake I made in the past is just that. It's the past. Nobody can hold me hostage with that. Why? Because I'm saying what God said about the matter. I'm confessing it out of my mouth. I am blessed and highly favored of the Lord. I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. My children are blessed. My children are favored. They are covered. I don't care if they're sitting in a jail cell right now. They're blessed. You got to learn how to speak what God says about the matter. Thank God in advance for opening the door. It might not be today or tomorrow, but God will perform his word. You got to learn how to stand on the word of God. I don't care what the situation is. If they're sick, if they're gangbanging, if they're doing whatever they don't need to do, guess what? Start speaking life today. God, I thank you that you're renewing and you're restoring my children. I thank you that they stop dealing drugs. I thank you that they stop prostituting. I thank you they stop sleeping around. God, clean out their mouths and clean out their hearts. God, give them a right mind and a right spirit. I thank you that they don't want to just shack up and live together, but they want a covenant marriage with you. God, I thank you that they will grow up and raise children to honor you and give you glory. Start speaking life over your children right now. Right now. So right where you are, my challenge to you, stand to your feet. Hallelujah. My challenge to you is to do better. My challenge to you is to do better. Guess what? That's my challenge to myself, is to do better. I want to be a better mother, a better wife, a better sister, a better friend, huh? Better at everything that God has called me to. I want to be a better pastor and a better preacher for you. Why? Because if I spend more time with God and I listen to God more, then I have more to give you, which makes you better. Amen? You got to want it. Ladies, those of you that want God to move in your life today, come on, if you want it, I need you to join me at the altar today. If you want something different for your children and for your relationships, I don't care if you're in a terrible relationship. God can turn it around, but you got to want it. God is not going to force anything on you. You've got to want it. And not just the ladies, men. Some of you need to stand behind your woman, just like they say, stand behind your man. You need to stand behind your woman and lift her hands up. Because while she's cooking and cleaning and washing and taking care of the house and taking care of the kids and riding them back here and forth and there and then coming home and taking care of you, there's a whole lot of things that women do that we experience, that we go through. And we've got to have somebody next to us. Hallelujah. Some of you, even if it's a sister or brother that needs the encouragement, that needs the help. Guess what? Everybody in here may not be a mother, but you have taken care of somebody's baby at some point in time. And God allowed you to take care of somebody's baby. Why? Because it was something that he needed to work in you. It was something that he needed to work in you. Hear me. You are great. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. No devil in hell can take from you what God put in you. Take it back. Take it back. Take the authority and the power that God has given you back. Stand up and stand strong like God has called you to. You don't have to trick. You don't have to manipulate. You don't have to upset. Just do what God said. Speak the word. Speak the word. God has got your back. Your husband and your family have your back. God is saying it's time for the truth. It's time for the truth. It is time for the truth. Hallelujah. Some of you have gifts that y'all scared to let loose and let go and let God. What you're holding on to it for? It ain't gonna help nobody out bottled up in you. It's time for you to stand up and be the woman that God has called you to. It's no more than just saying what God says. God has given you this opportunity today to be the best woman that you can be, to be the best mother that you can be. Guess what? Nobody's holding you hostage to the past life that you lived but you. So stop it. Stop crying about the mistakes that you made a long time ago. It's done. When you ask God to forgive you, he forgave you immediately. Now forgive yourself right where you're standing. Forgive yourself for not being everything that you thought you could be. Forgive yourself for not being perfect. God didn't call you to be perfect. He just called you to know him, love him, and serve him. Matter of fact, God didn't even call you to do what you do for your kids. He wants to do it through you. You got to allow God to work through you. Stop being scared about what somebody's going to say or what somebody's going to think. It doesn't matter what they think. They're not in control. God is. So ladies, take back what the enemy has stolen from you. Men, take your rightful place and pray for your helpmate. God gave her to you because you needed her. He gave you a helpmate. Cover her. Pray for her. And if you are not married, God is your covering. You got the best covering you could get. He wishes that we could all be single because then we'd have more time to spend with God. But for those of us that are married, we have the cares of this life and the cares of our husbands. And sometimes we don't have as much time to spend with God as we need. But hear me today. Stop letting the enemy punk you. Walk up, stand up rightly. And walk like God called you to walk. Stop letting people push you around. Stop worrying about what people think. Get them people off your back because that means they're not good for you. Get them out of your life because they're not good for you. And ask God to give you a plan. Ask him to give you directions. Ask him to show you what you need to do. Hear me. I lost my mom a few years ago. And I would do anything to just have her for 5 minutes. I said that on yesterday. You know what? And if I had her for 5 minutes, I wouldn't be asking her all kind of questions. I would just hug her and love her and squeeze her and thank God for what she taught me. Some of you better without. Come on, God will comfort your heart. Let somebody get in your life. Let another woman get in your life and hug you and squeeze you. We can't fall apart, ladies. This is war. This is spiritual warfare. You gotta fight. You gotta fight for what's important to you. Some of you invited your children to church today. Guess what? You invited them and they came because you are important to them. Now drop some word in their life, amen? So that you can become more than important. It don't have to be perfect, baby. Hear me. Don't have to be perfect. Don't have to be every time on time. Just love him. See, God sees the heart. People look at the outside, but God knows your heart. And that's what's important, because God does the changing. Mama can't change you. Daddy can't change you. God changes you. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you for each and every woman and every person at this altar. God, I ask that you would be glorified in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you that you give them back their joy and give them back their peace. And I thank you that you silence the voice of the enemy in their lives, that he would no longer tell them that they're not and that they can't and that they won't. But God, I thank you that they are blessed and highly favored of the Lord. God, that they have the power of the Lord. God, I thank you that you use them as you use Deborah, that they would be mighty in the kingdom of God. Lord, I thank you that they would speak those things that aren't as though they are, that they would trust and believe, God, what they can't see yet. But God, they'll walk in faith and they'll speak life to every situation, every person they come in contact with. God, I thank you that you use them to be warriors in the kingdom of God by the words that come out of their mouth, by the life that they live, by the examples that they set. And oh God, don't let one word be wasted. God, don't let one trouble and one trial be wasted. God, everything they've been through, let it be a testimony to where you brought them from, to where they're going. God, there's no shame in you. There's no shame in you. I bind every woman that has shame in the name of Jesus. I bind that shame off of their life. Curse it at the root that it would wither and die. There's nothing too hard for God. I thank you that you will walk in the newness and the favor of God. That you will open your mouth and say what God says. God, that we won't pity pat with the enemy, but we will tell our children and our loved ones the truth, that they can be set free. Now, God, help them to forgive themselves. Help them forgive every mistake, every wrong word, every misspoke word, every misunderstanding. God, help them to forgive themselves. Lord, we're not perfect, and you don't expect us to be, but you do expect us to try to move forward. And God, we'll be careful to give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. And I thank you, Lord, that every man in this room would walk uprightly before you and be the covering that he needs to be. And I thank you that every wife would be the helpmate that you need them to be. You don't need them to be in charge, Lord. You need them to be the helpmate. And I thank you that they would walk in that submission to your word unto their husbands. And God, I thank you that they would reign and walk together over their children in unity. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Let's give the Lord a hand praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, he's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised. Now,